Hi, it's Karen Harrison from the School Forest Program. Today we're going to look at tree buds. I'm here in Minneapolis, so I'm going to go for a neighborhood walk, check out some of the different tree buds that we can find on the boulevard trees, and maybe we'll make it to our local park where we can look at a few more. Today I'm putting a few things in my backpack so that I'm ready and prepared for our lesson. We're going to go over four things on our neighborhood walk today. We're going to learn what tree buds are. We'll go over the different parts of a twig, look at the differences between tree species, and then take an inside look at the tree bud. All right, I just walked about 5 blocks to a little park area not too far from my house. This way we can have a good look at a few different species and their buds, how they look different from each other. So what are buds? Buds are like little protective packages. Those buds have new parts of the plant, like leaves, stems, and flowers. They're made up of scales, and those scales create a waterproof barrier, protecting the inside of the bud until it's ready to emerge in the spring. There are two different kinds of buds. Side buds, like these two here, and a terminal bud at the very end of the branch. So as we look down the tree branch, you can see there are two more buds there, two more buds there. Those are all side buds. Here's a box elder tree. You'll notice the new leaves have already started to burst out of the bud. The bud has the different scales right here, and the new leaves are this light green at the end. Wow, check out these buds. They are already bursting open with new leaves. Definitely, we see some flowers that are going to be coming out soon. Here's another example. These ones aren't quite emerged yet, but the bud itself has started to elongate and is starting to open up at the end there. Here's one that's pretty easy to see any time of the year, the red bark of the dogwood. If we look at their buds, you'll notice they're kind of long and skinny, especially compared to some of the other buds we've seen. We've got the opposite-sided side buds, and the terminal bud, which is also pretty long and skinny. So unlike the dogwood, where the buds were on opposite sides of the branch from each other, this one has a bud on one side, and then farther down the branch, a bud on the opposite side. As we move down to the terminal bud, we can easily see those overlapping scales. Here's a species that has definitely a lot different bud from the last two we saw. It's not as long and skinny. It's more like short and stout. As we look at the side buds, they're pretty small. But what a unique thing, and what's easier to see on this species, are leaf scars. So underneath the bud, you'll notice kind of a half moon shape. That's called a leaf scar. It's where last year's leaf dropped off the tree. All right, so I'm back home after my walk to the park and back. I checked out a few of the trees on the boulevard as well as in the park. I brought a couple of samples back so we could take a look at them up close and right next to each other. Another thing you can do is take your ruler, measure how long the bud is. You can do the side buds as well as the terminal bud. So next, I took a little knife so I could cut into the bud. This one I cut from the top of the branch down to the end of the tip. As soon as I did that, I started seeing these little pieces kind of coming out. I took this one and I cut it straight down the side so we could look from the top view. Check out that cool design. If you're able to take a sample from one of your trees that you found, you could also tape it down to a piece of paper or inside your journal and then label with the different parts. You can also use a few to create a collage and compare and contrast differences. I hope you had fun and I hope you go out for a neighborhood walk yourself. Check out some buds. See which ones you can find in your neighborhood or even around your yard.